Hey, everyone. Say hello to my state-appointed inspirational social worker, Vern.
It's truly a pleasure to meet you all. Hey, Peter, looks like you've got yourself one super family. High five! All right!
So, Vern, what exactly is it that you do?
I'm here to lend a hand to my main man, Peter. Right, Peter?
Right.
High five! All right!
Done.
Peter!
What? I don't know any better.
Peter, I don't like this. You are really starting to take advantage of this whole situation.
Peter's just expressing himself. High five for expressing yourself, Peter. High five! All right!
This man seems bent on diluting the already watered-down significance of the elevated hand slap.
Hey, Stewie, high five.
Well, it's about time.
Psych.
Damn! I look even more foolish than when I was at that cocktail party. All right, you're gonna love this. So...
Oh, hang on a sec.
Okay, so these two black guys walk into a bar, and the bartender looks...
Hey, what are you guys talking about?
I was just telling a joke.
The bartender looks around and says, what'll you two fine gentlemen have? And, they paid their tab and couldn't have been more courteous.
All right, my first trip to a fast food joint as a retarded guy. Excuse me, pardon me, coming through, special needs. I'll have a, is this thing on? Attention restaurant customers. Testicles. That is all.
Give me that. Sorry, folks. Oh, my God. Is that what my voice sounds like? It's all whiny and nasally. Ugh.
You know what? I'm just going to get my own food.
Peter, get back here.
No freaking way. The fryer later. Oh, I am so taking this. Uh-oh. Lois, you look worse than that Rocky Dennis kid from Mask.
Rocky, I don't even know what you look like. Can I touch your face?
Of course, Diana.
Oh, God. Oh, God. What is this? What is all this? Am I touching the outside of a house? Oh, God. You're a monster.
I'm beautiful on the inside.
Yeah, but Rocky, there's a limit. Oh, what is this now? Does your face have a pelvis?
Oh, God, what have I done? I'm the worst husband ever.
Make that the worst father ever. Hi, I'm Agent Jessup from Child Services. I'm here to take your kids away.
What? Why?
Because you're mentally unfit to take care of them.
No way!
Oh, my God!
Finally!
I can't believe they took the kids away.
Well, at least Cleveland offered to take care of them.
Sorry you have to share a bed, boys. I'm a little short on space. Have a good sleep.
Hey, Chris. Whatever happened to Gina Davis? She used to be in movies, but she's not in movies anymore. She's attractive enough, but when she smiles, you see too much gum. Not a good tooth-to-gum ratio. Chris? I'll tell you tomorrow.
Thanks for letting my friend sleep over, Mr. Brown.
No problem, Meg. If y'all get hungry, there's some cottage cheese in the fridge. I'm gonna get me a spoonful now before y'all have at it.
Oh my God, Craig Hoffman's new car is so cool.
Oh my God, totally. I love the color.
Really? What color is it?
It's like blue, kind of blue-green. Oh, it's the same color as his eyes.
Oh wow, I bet he looks so hot driving it.
I heard he bought it from his dad.
Yeah, I remember his dad dropped him off at school in it one time when he was a freshman.
Doesn't his dad live in Hartford?
I think so.
My Aunt Sheila lives in Hartford. They have a mall there that's pretty cool. It's like part underground.
Oh, that's awesome!
Damn it, you guys are boring the crap out of me! Stupid mindless chatter is what it is. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm just gonna go back to my place and rent a dirty movie. This is ridiculous.
That was weird. Oh well. Hey, let's compare breasts.
Lois? Hey, how you doing, honey? Listen, there's no toilet paper in the bathroom, so I'm just gonna, there we go.
Oh, God, hang on!
Well, the doctors still don't know how much longer she's gonna have to be here.
I feel horrible, Brian. I put Lois in a hospital and I lost the kids. This is turning out worse than Stewie's iPod commercial.
Peter, you just need to show what a good father you are. Then you can get the kids back from Cleveland.
Wait a second, Brian, you're right! And the best way to do that is to show what a terrible father Cleveland is. This plan is so perfect, it's retarded.
Good evening, I'm Dan Rather, and tonight on CBS News, 7 Saudi soldiers sodomized several of Saddam's southern settlement squatters. I'm Dan Rather.
All right, come on, ladies, right this way. This'll show them that Cleveland's not fit to be a parent.
So, tell me, is there any tread left on the tires at all? Or at this point, would it be like throwing a hot dog down a hallway?
Oh, my lord, look who's here. Agent Jessup, look at all these prostitutes.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
7. 7 prostitutes.
This is a shakedown.
Mr. Griffin, this isn't going to work.
Yeah, Peter, you and 5 of those prostitutes, get out.
So, in conclusion, Peter Griffin, you've inspired me to distrust all mentally challenged parents. Thank you, Your Honor.
And thank you, Agent Jessup, for your comically misleading remarks. Mr. Griffin, do you have anything to say in your defense as to why this court should return custody of your children to you?
Your Honor, I would like to call to the stand my surprise witness, the ghost that never lies. Ooh. But I'm the only one who can see him and hear him, so I'll let everyone know what he's saying and doing.
Objection, Your Honor. This is ridiculous.
Overruled. I'll allow it. You better be going somewhere with this, Mr. Griffin.
Thank you, Your Honor. Ghost that never lies, did you witness the events that took place on that fateful day? You did. Well, how interesting. And do you see the culprit or culprits in this courtroom today? You do? Yeah. Well, would you kindly point him or them out for this court? Don't point at me, you jackass!
Well, if there's nothing further, I hereby sentence...
Wait, Your Honor. There is something further. Look, I know I screwed up big time, but I only did it so I could get my kids back. I love them. And I think it's a bum rap that just because I'm retarded, that makes me an unfit parent. There are plenty of unfit parents out there who aren't retarded, but they get to keep their kids. Bing Crosby, Joan Crawford, I think the Ramsey's still got one left. I just want them back, Your Honor, and you're the only one who can help me. What do you say?
Are you kidding? You're a monster. In fact, if I could, I would put you in a place where you would be removed from the general public. Perhaps locked in a big secure building with other dangerous people for a predetermined period of time based on the nature and degree of your offense. Unfortunately, as far as I know, no such place exists. So, I have no choice but to set you free.
Does that mean I get my kids back?
Absolutely not. Case closed.
Oh, crap. Oh, it was prison you were thinking of. Prison.
Oh, I already banged the hammer.
And now, back to Jake and the Fat Man.
Hey, look over here on the carpet. That's a cigarette butt. This is probably evidence.
What do you think was in that Danish? You think it was cheese? Because I got a little problem with cheese.
Hey, I'm talking about evidence here. There's lipstick on it.
Yeah, well, can you bring it over to me?
I can't move it. This is a crime scene.
Well, can you describe it to me?
You know what? Forget it. I'll take care of this, okay?
Oh, no. Just let me close my eyes for a minute.
Look, I know his wife is a smoker. Just yesterday, when we saw her at the country club, she had a cigarette in her hand.
What, so that's it, Peter? You're just giving up?
I don't know what else to do, Brian. I guess we're never gonna be a family again.
Peter.
Oh, my God, Lois! You're all better!
That's right. And the doctors say I'll smell like French fries for the next 6 months.
I'll enjoy that.
And Peter, I got a surprise for you.
You got the kids back! Oh, I love you so much, delicious French fry wife.
Now we can live with you again, even though you're a dangerous retard.
Don't say retard, Chris. We prefer to be called little people. Because there's nothing wrong with being mentally challenged. In fact, I've learned that we are superior people. Above all, you dumb brainy smarties. Someday you will beg us for mercy, and we will consider it.
Isn't it wonderful that everything's back to normal?
Yeah. Oh, God, nobody move.
What is it?
Nothing. I'll get it.